Today, I read a very disturbing news. A 9-year-old girl was raped by a bunch of 9-year-old boys. Gang raped. Now, that is very sad and pity the girl because her life will never be the same. She has lost her virginity at a very young age. She suffers a psychological trauma, a physical trauma, and it will bring. This thing will bring throughout to her marriage and her entire life. Her life is scarred permanently by the acts of these 9-year-old boys. Now, these 9-year-old boys are minors. They are below 18. And therefore, whenever they commit a crime, they don't go to prison. Such is our law. Our laws are like that. So therefore, now, does our law allow them to go scot-free? There's no consequences. Now, because of these 9-year-old boys doing, this girl's 9-year-old girl life will never be the same. Now, even at kids level, there has to be equity. We have law for a reason. Why is there law? Law is to ensure apa? Justice. There must be justice. There must be fairness. There must be order. There must be a regulated conduct of people of all ages. Even though you're a 9-year-old, you can cause permanent damage. You can rape, you can kill, you can steal. There are implications. Granted that at 9 years old, you are not of completely sound mind, not like an adult, to be able to make informed choices in life. You can end up being naughty and do things that you would not do if you were an adult. But at 9-year-old, what you do, even though you're not an adult, can affect another person's life until her or his adulthood. So therefore, as far as law is concerned, if we see this, whether we're a guy or woman or adult or whatever, old person, younger person, if we feel this is unfair, we feel something is not right, that's because Allah, or if you don't believe in Allah, God or nature, install this sense of balance in us, and this balance now is tilted, and we don't feel it is right. We feel that something needs to be done to uphold justice, to restore justice for this girl. Now, our laws are written as such. But it doesn't mean it cannot be rewritten. It can be in parliament. If we collectively, the government and the opposition, feels that something needs to be done, it needs to be done. It needs to change. Because surely these 9-year-old boys cannot go scot-free without consequences to them after they have caused the most severe consequences to this girl, to this poor girl. She was gang raped. Just because it is 9-year-olds does not mean that it is less severe to her than if adults were to do that to her. Faham tak? Nampak tak beza dia? And she experienced that at the age of 9, whereas other women may have experienced that at the age of 20 or 30. So she, the damage to her is worse than damage to an adult. It was not consenting. Jadi, I think it's only proper, it's only responsible kita sebagai rakyat, society yang bertamadun to review and look at our laws balik. We can't put 9-year-olds into prison, but they should not be enjoying life like other kids are now. They should be sent to juvenile. They must serve juvenile, and if katakan statutory rape, katakan is 20 tahun dan sebatan. Now, these kids are 9 years old. They must be in some form of detention for 20 years. Now, for the first, 18 is where dia become, boleh masuk jail kan? So dia 9, 9 tahun dia patut masuk juvenile. And in juvenile, dia patut kena rotan. Bukan rotan macam penjara tu. But dia kena patut kena rotan macam guru besar punya rotan. Okay, and how many strokes the court should decide? In juvenile. Dia tak masuk jail lah. Tapi in juvenile, they must be isolated from other kids. They must be disciplined. They must not enjoy the same kind of life that other 9-year-olds enjoy because what they have done is unforgivable. They stay there until they graduate juvenile. The remaining years, they continue to serve in prison. They have to go to prison. Tak ada sebatan lagi dah. Sebatan dah terima dah masa dia 9 tahun. Sepatutnya. They serve the balance and they come out. When they come out, they get to live normal life balik. This girl, bila dia umur 20 tahun from now, she's 29, her life is still not the same. She would have suffered the trauma. So therefore, you know, no matter what we do to the boys pun, this girl's life can never be restored. Tapi at least, there must be penance. There must be penalty. Even when you're 9-year-old, you must. So that that can be a lesson. That can be a deterrent to other 9-year-olds, rapist wannabes. Because kalau tidak, lepas ni 9-year-old, 10-year-old, 11-year-olds, no issue lah. Rape lah anak siapa-siapa pun. Because there's no consequences what? Polis kata tak boleh investigate, tak boleh buat apa. So now police may be interpreting the law correctly. Maybe the law is like that. But the lawmakers, come on, do the right thing. Do the right thing. Yang dah lepas, lepas yes. But future, way forward, do the right thing. Because if you don't do the right thing, the conscience will be on you. What if your daughter now kena rape? Imagine politicians, parliamentarians, your daughters yang below umur 12, kalau kena rape dengan budak-budak yang tua sikit, and nothing can be done to them. Are you okay with that? Jangan fikir tak boleh jadi pada anak-anak kita, ya. Think. So therefore, please make sure undang-undang, the laws in the country is right and fair. Ensure that. Because law is there to protect us, to regulate the conduct of the citizens, termasuk kanak-kanak, to ensure kesejahteraan semua dan keselamatan semua orang. We don't want to go to work worrying that our women can be raped or assaulted, and there can be no consequences. Anybody should know that whatever they do will come, such a thing will come with grave consequences. The government is to ensure it. So parliamentarians, kalau dengar ni, please do the right thing. Gubal the right kind of laws. Law kita tak adequate. Kalau in this particular case, there is no justice to that girl. And these 9-year-olds boys go scot-free after having enjoyed ravaging this poor girl. Hope it makes sense. Not sure how many people will resonate with this. But look at it from a balanced perspective. Imagine your own daughter. Imagine if your son were to do this to other daughter pun. Imagine all aspects. Fair ke? Kita mungkin okay kalau anak lelaki kita buat pada anak perempuan lain. Tapi kalau anak perempuan kita kenal macam mana? Imagine both sides. I'm not okay if my son does this to a girl. I want him to suffer the consequences. If my daughter experiences, I want whoever does that to suffer the same consequences. It should not be allowed. Hope that clarifies. Hope it resonates with people. Hope it reaches the ears of the powers that be and the lawmakers in parliament. With 2/3 majority, we can change the law.
if you have any interesting ideas that can help build a better Malaysia, please put them in the comment section. And if you haven't subscribed, do subscribe. The subscription is free, you don't have to pay money. And we don't, you know, YouTube doesn't give us your information. So there's no list of subscribers. I just know the number of subscribers, but no information about who the subscribers are. And we are not monetized, so there's no advertisements. When you click on our videos, you straight away watch our videos. You don't have to see annoying ads. Anyway, now please subscribe if you haven't done so, and please share our videos far and wide. Terima kasih. Wassalam.
See more content like this? Make sure to like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell notification so you don't miss any new videos.